So if we have a study and we're given the mean, it says they were trying to determine the mean SAT score of graduating high school seniors. So they found the mean score is 506 with a margin of error of 12. So we want to write a confidence interval for the actual true SAT score for graduating high school seniors. So remember what we talked about is that this is a sample. We took a sample of high school seniors because we couldn't take the population. We couldn't measure every single graduating high school senior in the country. So we just took a sample and we figured out what their mean is. And then through some math, which we're not going to learn in this course, they found the margin of error was 12. And so what we believe is that the mean score, or the average score of people, is about 506, but that we have a margin of error of 12, which means that our actual mean may be 12 less than what we thought it was, or 12 more than what we thought it was. So all we have to do to write our confidence interval is we just take 506 and we add 12 and we subtract 12, and that's our actual confidence interval. So we're saying that it's very likely that our actual mean for all graduating high school seniors for our entire population, not just our sample, is somewhere in between 494 and 518. So here's another one with a especially with election season coming up, you are going to hear tons of these. So they gave a sample of voters in the United States about their preference for a candidate. The percentage of people who said they preferred candidate A was 73%. That's a really high percentage for a presidential candidate. The margin of error for the survey was 2.5%. Write a confidence interval for the percentage of the population that supports candidate A. So this happened in the last election, where there's this confidence, or there's this percent that they believe this many percent of people are supporting a certain candidate. And then when all the votes came in, they found, oh, oops, our margin of error told us that this person didn't get quite as many votes as we thought they would because the margin of error. So they think that the candidate A is going to have 73% of the votes, but we have a margin of error of 2.5%, which means that our actual population is going to be 2.5% this way and 2.5% this way. So our actual population mean is going to be somewhere between 70.5 and 75.5. Because our sample was 73, our actual population mean is very, very likely in between 70.5 and 75.5, which would still, in this case, make the candidate win. So that's when a margin of error doesn't come back to bite you. But truly, pay attention to those margins of error, because oftentimes the margin of error tells you, like, you think you're really confident. You're like, oh yeah, this is very, very likely that the average is this. And then that margin of error really, it could be lower, it could be higher.